Hi, this is Freddy from Switzerland with another episode of the Show and Tell Knife Overview series in collaboration with Tell Knives from Switzerland, which is a Swiss online store with some great prices and a great knife selection out of the French-speaking part of Switzerland. And you can find them under www.tellknives.ch. And I would highly recommend to check out their store and their great prices. You will find a link to their store and to the specific knife that I'm taking a look at today in the description box below. And if you buy a knife from them, please let them know that you came to them through this video. So today we are going to take a look at a Spyderco knife that I always looked at ever since it came out. I believe it came out last year or early this year. I can't really put my finger on that, but it was a very interesting knife, and it's a new Spyderco collaboration in their long-lasting relationship with Lionsteel Knives out of Italy. So two great manufacturers collaborating on a couple of their knives. Before, there have been a lot of Spyderco knives built in collaboration with Lionsteel, like for example the Lion Spy and so on. And here we have the Spy Opera, which is a crossover between a very Spyderco inspired blade and a handle shape used by Lionsteel on their Opera models. There is a mini and a regular size Opera with a very, very similar handle shape and a more traditional kind of a drop point blade shape, and I believe a thumb stud opener. And here we have the Spy Opera, which is a collaboration on both of these companies. And you can really see the influence of Lionsteel in the handle. Beautiful natural micarta, some decorative screws, a non-revealed pivot there. Then we have the crown spine on the blade, as well as the crown backlock, also around the titanium backspacer. Here we have the Spyderco influence with the wire pocket clip. And of course, Spyderco is well known for doing some nice backlocks in their lineup. Some of their most popular models, like the Endura, the Delica, and some other models, are primarily designed to be a backlock knife. So, certainly a rich history there with some good knives from Spyderco that use a backlock. At the moment, backlocks are not the hottest kind of locking system in the knife market. There certainly have been some more fidget friendly or just more popular knife locks. For example, in terms of Spyderco, of course, their compression lock, but also the access or able locks on button locks, also of course frame and liner locks, and even the Spyderco ball lock has been more popular than a backlock. These are really some old locking style knives, but they certainly are good locking systems. And for a no-nonsense EDC knife, I think a backlock can certainly be the right choice for you. And here we have something that is very interesting in terms of a higher class, well done, kind of no-nonsense EDC for a lot of different people, in my opinion. So let's take a look at the specs here of the Spy Opera. We have an overall length of 6.9 inches or 17.5 centimeters, with a blade length of 2.88 inches or 7.4 centimeters, so certainly under 3 inches, which makes this legal in a lot of places where you can have a one-handed opening locking knife. And we have a blade stock of 3 millimeters, so pretty standard with that gorgeous rounded spine right there. And the steel, of course, if you're doing something higher end with Lion Steel, it's going to be M390, which you certainly can see it is here as well. And then we have a handle length of just at 4 inches or 10.1 centimeters, and a weight here on this construction with natural colored micarta over stainless steel liners, as well as a titanium backspacer with a wire clip of 74 grams or 2.61 ounces. So certainly also very lightweight and under that ounce and inch requirement that some people might have. In terms of pricing, from tellknives.ch, you're looking at 204 Swiss francs, which is a pretty competitive price compared to some other Swiss and European retailers. And then there is the US price, which is 175 for M390 micarta built in Italy by Lionsteel, which is also mentioned here on the blade, built in Maniago, Italy by Lionsteel. So these are the basic specs on this knife. Also, looking at the Poco Clip, we have the standard kind of spider hook wire Poco Clip, which works great, but in some cases can cause a hotspot here. It's pretty good. If you really bear down, you can feel the Poco Clip because it actually is quite high up here with those little edges. For my hand size, it's not a real issue actually. A thing that I noticed that I find a bit odd about the Poco Clip is, first off, it's not reversible, which certainly would have been nice on a knife that's otherwise very ambidextrous with a backlock as well as a whole deployment. So that is certainly a miss in my book. Just mill those two ridges in there and then you have a nice ambi knife. So that's not really a thing that I understand in terms of the decision that they took there. We also got a very small lanyard attachment point right there, and here also the edges are slightly not sharp but a bit pokey, and depending on how you hold the knife you can actually feel the very last point of the handle there where they made this little cutout. So not a big deal, but just something I noticed. Also, the Poco Clip screw is also like a decorative screw, but different from the body screws, which I find also quite a bit odd. It looks a bit like something they took out of a parts bin from some of their other line steel knives, because it doesn't really fit the star kind of pattern that they have on the body screws. It's just something very different. So that's also a little thing that I noticed. Other than that, let's do some kind of size comparison so you can get a good feel for the size of the Spy Opera. First off, we have the Shirogorov F95NL and the Shirogorov Neon Zero, and you can see it's smaller than both of these knives. Then we have our Benchmark EDC blades from Benchmade and Spyderco. First off, we have the Benchmade full-size Bug Out, the top there, and the Spyderco Para 3. And you can see smaller than both, certainly less broad than a Para 3, but also a bit broader than a Bug Out. In terms of overall appearance and feel and hand, is certainly closer to a Bug Out than a Para 3. You can see that here, nice and slender handle. In terms of thickness, a bit thicker than a Bug Out, especially in the blade thickness, but also not too bad in terms of slenderness and ease of carry in the pocket. But of course, because you have that Spidey hump there, it is going to be a bit broad in this dimension, pretty close to a Para 3 actually at the highest point, but then it falls off a little bit quicker here on this Spy Opera. We have some other comparisons that are more specific to this knife. For example, we have a Viper Key, which is a slip joint, but also sports some nice micarta and is larger than the Spy Opera. Then we have the Reinhold Rhino by Spyderco in CTS XHP, which is a smaller knife, but in terms of blade size or blade length, actually quite close. Also, this is a super ergonomic knife once you swap out the Poco Clip right there, and this sports the compression lock instead of a backlock. I don't have any other backlock knife in my collection because it's certainly not a lock that I like to operate and have in my EDC knives. And if the knife isn't something that I really, really love, I normally steer away from a backlog just because of personal preference. I don't think that they have any kind of security issue. I just don't like how you operate backlogs, and that's why I normally don't choose them if I can have something else. Then we have another knife from Quiet Carry. This is the Quiet Carry Drift, also a button, a hole operated folder, which is very close in the overall size right there. But I can see that the Spyderco actually will have about the same or even a bit more cutting edge here because you don't have the forward finger choil. So that's certainly a nice thing. Hand length very, very close. Of course, this is going to be a thinner knife and a knife with an amazing steel with that Vanex. And two other comparisons I have for you is the Wee Knife Banter right there, which is very close in the overall size. And then another micarta handled folder. Here we have the Riyadh Bushido, both very close in overall size. I think this should give you a good idea. It's about the size of a Banter in terms of thickness. Also, I think pretty comparable there. So very close to a Banter, just with a Spyderco and Line Steel kind of styling and overall fit and finish. Also here, this is a bit of a thicker handle, as you can see. Pretty much big difference in terms of the micarta. I think this is a linen micarta. It's a very finely knit and also polished, so there's not a lot of texture in the micarta. If you compare that, for example, to the one here on the Viper Key, this is a pretty big difference there. So you don't get the very nice textile feel that you get from some micartas here, because it's actually quite polished. And of course, you have that natural kind of brownish look that you get from that kind of micarta, and it's not a green micarta that you might see on some listings in some stores. So let's take a closer look at the blade right here. So as I said before, this is a show and tell first impressions kind of video, so I haven't done any kind of excessive use or testing with these blades. This is just my first experience. I have cut a very limited amount of paper just to check out the original edge from the factory, and that was actually very well done. We have a almost full flat grind, just sparing out the top part where we have the hole right there, and it actually cuts really well for the things that I have done. It also comes down to a pretty thin edge, not exceptionally so, but a very nice using kind of blade geometry. Of course, as I said before, nice rounded spine, not too thin of a tip there, so still pretty precise, but maybe a bit thicker than I would have liked. I would like to see a slightly thinner tip for a smaller kind of EDC knife like you have it right here. In terms of aesthetic, I think the blade is actually quite nice looking. I like the slight curve right here. Just a very, very neat looking Spyderco inspired blade. It's of course a very Spyderco type blade with that large hump for the opening hole, but I like that they didn't went with a leaf shaped blade. I think it looks much better the way that they have done it here. In terms of the handle, very, very comfortable. I have a small to medium hand, 7.5 sterile glove. Fits my hand very well. You have a very good ramp here in the front. It's a bit steep maybe, so if it was slightly less steep, it would even be a bit more comfortable, but then you can also go into foregrip here. I would love to see some slight jimping here like you see on some of the Giant Mouse knives. That would really be a great spot right there to do some nice and detailed cutting, but you can also use it like this to do some like food preparation and things like that. So the overall design of that blade is actually very function driven, like you see on a lot of Spyderco knives. And the handle is comfortable, no real sharp corners. In the left hand, the clip here for me really becomes a ergonomic kind of issue. It's very uncomfortable for my pinky and ring finger there in the back, but right-handed, not really something to worry about. The action is very nice. You get the slight stick on that backlog, but I think that would work itself out once you use and carry the knife. But the overall action is very, very smooth. Really well done. Not really free falling, but not a lot of backlogs are actually. But the actual way to manipulate the knife is very rewarding. Nice and smooth, very defined. And just a joy to actually deploy. And you can also hear the lockup with the back lock is super solid, no wiggle in any direction. So certainly if you like a back lock or just want some no-nonsense EDC with a good looking overall design and just a little bit more, something a little bit more traditional overall, I think the Spy Opera could be a great fit for you. There are some issues here and there, but nothing really major. You get certainly a great steel with the M390, very good overall fit and finish and attention to detail. If you're a lefty, you will have the issue with the clip. in terms that it's not reversible, but other than that, I think it's a good looking, interesting collaboration with Spyderco and Lion Steel. And certainly, if you're looking for a sub 3-inch, no nonsense EDC, I think this could be a knife for you. And you see, the action is so smooth that you even can thumb flick it as well as Spidey flick it with a backlock. If you give it some wrist there, you can easily spider flick it, and that is certainly an achievement on a backlock, and just overall a very interesting knife, and I think a well done collaboration between these two companies. So this was my overview here in this show and tell series. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up and follow me on Instagram at 7ready_knife_reviews. Also, don't forget to follow Tell Knives on Instagram and check out their website. You will find a link to this particular model in the description below. And if you buy something, please let them know I sent you. And thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.